Most research intensive universities that concentrate on STEM subjects have a glassblowing workshop with one or two glassblowers there. I'm Phil Jones, I'm the scientific glassblower for the University of Bath, and I'm based in the Department of Chemistry. Glassblowing in its form as we know today has been a trade that's been practiced in thousands of years. Scientific glassblowing specifically though, although rudimentary pieces of glassware were made in the 19th century, even back to Galileo's time some elementary pieces were made. They'd be mostly made out of a kind of glass called soda glass, which is essentially the same kind of glass things like jam jars are made out of these days. So it wasn't really until the advent of a kind of glass called borosilicate glass in probably the 1920s, 30s, that some of the more technical scientific glassware started to be produced. Scientific glassblowing is different to what you might think of as traditional glassblowing, where they blow down the metal punty and create things like goblets and vases and ornamental things. I mean, through the course of a year, I get through hundreds of jobs that involved making thousands of pieces. This is to create a filtration unit the use from one of the research labs in chemistry. Working temperature of glass is around 1250 Celsius. Flame itself is probably around about 2000 degrees, but to get glass into its molten form, which is the state in which you can start to blow it and shape it, it's around 1250. Scientific glassblowing is listed as an endangered art purely because there's probably only 100 or so of us practicing the full field of scientific glassblowing. At the end of the day, I've got something tangible, there's something I can show for my efforts, and hopefully this piece goes on to help with the next scientific breakthrough. I guess that's the ultimate goal.